Hello friends, this is Priyanka. Today we are going to solve a problem on cooling and adiabatic humidification with the help of psychrometric chart. So what is the meaning of adiabatic? That means enthalpy remains constant. So first I will read what is the given problem. 200 meter cube of air per minute is passed through the adiabatic humidifier. The condition of air at inlet is 40 degrees Celsius, dry bulb temperature and 15% relative humidity. Outlet condition is 25 degrees Celsius, dry bulb temperature and 20 degrees Celsius, wet bulb temperature. Find the dew point temperature and the amount of water vapor added to the air per minute. So this was the given problem. Now, let us first understand this problem with the help of a diagram. Now, what is the initial condition of air? So here, it is given that 200 meter cube per minute of air. So this is the V1 that we have to take. Then the temperature is also given. So TD1, 40 degrees Celsius, and the relative humidity, Phi1, 15% is given. And what is the outlet condition? So outlet condition, the dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature is given. So we have to write TD2 is equal to 25 degrees Celsius and TW2 is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Now we have to write this data. So what is the initial condition of air? That means the condition of air at point 1. So V1 200 meter cube per minute, TD1 40 degrees Celsius, Phi1 15%. And what is the final condition of air? That is TD2 25 degrees Celsius and TW2 20 degrees Celsius. So this is the data that we have to write. Now we have to plot the point 1 and point 2 as per the given data. So for the point 1, dry bulb temperature is given, that is 40 degrees Celsius. So on this horizontal line, the dry bulb temperature is given. So here is 40 degrees Celsius. So we have to take a vertical line from this temperature and we have to extend this up to a relative humidity 15%. So if we observe these inclined lines indicate the humidity or relative humidity in percentage. So here is 10%, 20%, 30%. So we have to select the inclined line with 15% relative humidity and this vertical line from the temperature with this inclined line, 15% relative humidity, there is the point of intersection. And this point will give us the point 1. Now, in the same way, we have to select the point 2. So here the dry bulb temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius, is given. So we have to select one vertical line from 25 degrees Celsius. Now, how to select the wet bulb temperature? So here the wet bulb or saturation temperature in degrees Celsius is given. So here 10, 15, 20, 25. So these are the temperatures are given. Now from these temperatures, there are the inclined lines. And these inclined lines indicate the wet bulb temperature. So we have to take the inclined line from 20 degrees Celsius and this inclined line and this vertical line from this 25 degrees Celsius. The point of intersection will give us the point 2. And then we have to join this point 1 and point 2. Now we have to measure what is the dew point temperature at this point 2. So how to measure? Now if we observe, we have to draw one horizontal line from this point 2. Now here the wet bulb temperature is given. So this 15, 20, 25, these are the temperatures. And from this temperature, there are horizontal lines. So these horizontal lines indicates that this is the dew point temperature. Now we have to extend the horizontal line, that is the line parallel to this line, horizontal lines passing through this point 2. Now this red line indicates the dew point temperature where it intersects this inclined line, where the temperatures are given. So we have to measure the temperature at this point. So what is the temperature at this point? That is dew point temperature TdP2 is equal to 17.6 degrees Celsius. So this is the dew point temperature. Now we will find out what is the specific volume at point 1. Now if we observe here, the red lines, red inclined lines indicate the specific volume, and what is the unit meter cube per kilogram of dry air, that is also given. So for this red inclined lines, we have to take the parallel line but passing through point 1, and then we have to measure the value. So that is specific volume, that is VS1 is equal to 0.896 meter cube per kilogram of dry air, and we have to note down that. Now we will measure what is the specific humidity at point 1 and at point 2. So how to measure? So if we observe here on this vertical line, the specific humidity is given in kilogram per kilogram of dry air. So we will take here the horizontal lines but passing through this point 1 and point 2. So I have shown here with the help of red lines. So what is the omega 1? So here it is after 0.006, that is it is equal to 0.007. and what is the value of omega 2? So omega 2 is equal to 0.0126 kilogram per kilogram of dry earth. So we have to use the same unit as given in the psychrometric chart. Now we have to note down all this data, and now we will calculate what is the mass of air supplied. So here V1 is given in the problem, and VS1 that we have selected from the psychrometric chart. So mass of air supplied, that is MA, is equal to V1 by VS1. So it is equal to 200 by 0.896, which is equal to 223.2 kilogram per minute. Now what is the amount of water added, water vapor added? So MA multiplied by the difference in the specific humidity, that is omega 2 minus omega 1. So if we calculate this, we will get the answer 1.25 kilogram per minute. So this is the answer.